All right, thank you all for coming out here. It will have another interesting, eclectic collection of music. We're trying this room today. For Alan's benefit, don't spill your drink.
Food's okay though.
Spill all the food you want.
No breadcrumbs.
Of course, then we're just going to be hungry up here and staring at you.
Yeah, that's okay. Your food's over here.
All right, so starting off, we have a collection of three different very famous artists. Hopefully famous, hopefully you've heard of them. And then we're going to finish it off with a very famous dance, and no, I cannot convince Jordan into hearing it. So we're going to start off with a pair of Billy Joel songs, first one of which, quite famous. In fact, I have a little screen capture from the video. They recognize Christine Brinkley from Billy Joel. Billy Joel actually looks a lot younger in that one. From the early 80s. So without further ado, this is our version of Uptown Girl. Part of it. musically, this is a little technically challenging. It's actually a reggae song. No one ever heard it as a reggae song because the drummer threw his sticks at Billy Joel and said, "I hate reggae," and they changed it in their actual recording. So we are going to play a rock song done as a shuffle to a reggae beat. And so when we first started playing this, it was interesting. And thankfully, we don't have any recordings of us trying this initially. But you'll see, it's a little bit different. So without further ado, here's Only the Good Die Young.
Thank you.
Felt the job did a lot of upbeat stuff, but we threw that one in because got a business song. So contrary to popular belief, the song came out right before our bicentennial, I think, 1975. He didn't write this for the U.S. as much as we like to commandeer things. Philadelphia Freedom was actually written by his about his famous or his favorite female tennis player, Billie Jean King. Her team were called the Philadelphia Freedoms. The song was actually written for them. We just, again, took it for our bicentennial celebration. So further ado, this is a Philadelphia Freedom, well, which I've been wondering.
Thank you.
Strap down song.
You should know this one.
Quite famous.
A
little backstory on this one too. There's a reason why it's called Crocodile Rock. He was visiting Australia and he was watching a rock band, and I can't remember their name, in Australia, and he was inspired by them. And so he's trying to emulate their sound, and because they're Australian, he decided to call this Crocodile Rock.
Nice.
And then do here's Crocodile Rock.
Thank you.
figured a band with five males and one woman wouldn't be complete without this one. Five males.
Oh, oh yeah!
Woo!
You're wrong. Yeah. Where's the six person? Oops, I can't count. This is actually a Carole King cover of a famous Aretha Franklin song. This is I Feel Like a Natural Woman. Don't quote me on this.
Thank you. movie was just a couple years ago, right?
We're not that old.
It was just a couple years ago.
There's so many good songs.
We couldn't possibly
do
that. No. I need a picture of the band, please. Yay, thank you, yay.
She's a roadie.
Because we don't know the nature band to name the group. Right? Exactly.
I guess we need to ask for the incentive that is happening to be on that
Okay, picture band. Adam, get in here, mister.
You're welcome.
You guys rock. I get very excited.
Oh.
Can you get your guitar? What is this?
Sorry, we play this.
Right there. No, no.
Stop. Okay, ready? One.
Tim is a part-time member.
Perfect. Hey! Thank you!
Name that band.